Pastor Anthony Miles and his wife Christy, we want to thank you for choosing to spend part of your weekend here with us today. If this is your first time here, I'd like to let you know a little bit about what you can expect. First, the worship team is going to come out and lead you in some worship, and then our lead pastor, Pastor Miles, is going to share a message from our series, What If? Your time here with us today will be a little bit over an hour, but before we get started with service today, there's a few things we'd like you to know. Night of Worship is coming up on January 29th at the Windham High School. This is a time where all of our campuses get together to worship God. To sign up to attend this event, go to graniteunited.com/events. Our Warriors United and Shine United groups kick off next month at Granite United Church. This is a great time to build community and grow deeper in the Word of God. For more information and to sign up, go to graniteunited.com/groups. For more information on anything I just talked about, or to learn more about our church, you can go to graniteunited.com. If this is your first time here today, we encourage you to fill out a connection card. Those are located in the seat backs in front of you. Or you can download the Granite United app. Again, we want to thank you for joining us today, and we hope you enjoy the service.
Thank you. sing our hearts out to Jesus. Let's sing it from the rooftops that He is an amazing, amazing God. Let's raise our hands and declare the victory in your life. Raise it as victory because He is victorious. So let's sing this from our hearts.
know you guys can do it way better than that. Give it up one more time for this. What's up, Grammy United? My name is Eddie James. I'm on behalf of our lead pastor, Anthony Miles, and his wife, Christy, our campus pastor, Joe, and his wife, Shelley. Welcome to Grammy United Church. Grammy United is one church. Everybody say one church.
One church!
In multiple locations. Thank you for coming to Mars. Then you don't say that word. Guys, if you're a first-time guest, please grab a connection card. It's right in front of you, or to your left or your right. You're sitting on the front row, right behind you. Please fill it out. It's a great way to ask any type of questions you want to ask. I know when I first started coming to Granite, I had a list. Pastor Joe, unfortunately, had to field those questions, and he did a great job with it. And I'm still here, so ask any questions you want to ask. Let us know what's going on in your life, if you need prayer, anything you're willing to take the next step. Proverbs 22:6 tells us, lead your children while they're young, and while as they get older, they will not stray. That speaks volumes of my life. When I first started coming to Granite, I came for my children. I came only because of my children. My fiance at the time, I'm sorry, my girlfriend at the time, wanted a godly man. That wasn't me. So when we got the invite to Granny, I was like, all right, I'll try it out. I know that's what she wants. My kid, I just had my daughter. And I was like, okay, I'll go check it out. That first Sunday, God hit me with a left, then a right, and an uppercut, and raised my hand. And I accepted into my life, and it's been a what happens here happens in those four classrooms outside. But we need you guys to fill some voice that we have. If working with kids or working with young adults, because you also have a youth group, is in your heart, please speak to Pastor Joe at the end of service, and we'll sign you guys up. We have a few hosts to fill in our kids ministry, and we can use you at a youth group. If that's where you are, If working with teens is in your heart, please let me know. Please let Pastor Joe know. And Jonathan's somewhere around here. He's our recruiter. He's out back, waving his hands. Please let him know. With that said, you guys have been awesome. Stand up. Give each other a high five. Welcome each other. And,
celebrate when people take these kind of steps. Amen. So one more time, let's celebrate that. So why am I talking about that right here? Because as you guys know, we're getting ready for the offering, right? Let's give it up for the offering. why I want to talk about that right now is because I want to help connect the dots here. Because these lives that have been forever changed by Jesus Christ, it only happens because the givers have paved the way. Now, I'm not taking anything, it's obviously Jesus that changes people's hearts. It's Jesus that saves people. It's all about Jesus. However, this location doesn't exist without the givers who gave before so that we could do this.
Amen.
The Lowell campus doesn't exist without the givers here that gave so we could launch Lowell. So as a giver, you can know that all around, all of our campuses have baptisms today. There's going to be 7 just here alone. In all of our campuses, there are baptisms today. And if you are a giver, man, thank you. Because of your faithful giving, because of your biblical obedience, we are seeing people all around New England take steps of faith. And man, that is just so awesome to know that one day, it's when we, because instead of thinking of the here and now, we're thinking about that when and then. One day when we stand before Jesus, all the steps that are taken because you are a faithful giver, that is attributed to you. Think about that. Think about the incredible impact that you got to be a part of. And then Jesus Christ is looking down and smiling, so happy that we took that step of faith. That's awesome, amen? Amen. So if you've never given, I encourage you, get on board. Not just because it's a biblical command, not just because we need to keep the lights on, because that's not an issue, but because it's an opportunity for you to enter into a divine partnership with God, where your faithfulness intersects with His faithfulness and blessing is the result. And man, it is just such an incredible place to be in that sweet spot. With that said, I just want to pray for the offering and we'll continue with the worship. Father, I'm so thankful for you and for how your perfect plan works through us, Father. It is just such an incredible privilege to get to be a part of your work, Father, and I pray that this offering will be pleasing to you. I pray that you will take this, and as you have done time and time and time again, just do far greater with it than we could ever hope or dream, Father. Just like you promised us in your word, when we step out in faith, your faithfulness intersects with that, Father, and we just get to see you do so much through us, and it is so amazing, Father. We're so grateful and thankful for this opportunity to partner with you, Father. We love you. We give you the glory for what you're going to do in this house today. And all God's kids said,
Amen.
Let's continue to worship our God. He's worthy of all praise.
Amen. Let's put our hands together for the Lord today. Amen.
Amen. Karen, I hope you guys were blessed by today's service. I know I was. I find that stuff it's just so awesome to really stop and think about how important it is to endure that season. That was the point that really jumps out to me, is to endure that season and not be looking always for that instant gratification, thinking that, you know, oh, I took this one step so everything's going to be all right. It takes time. One thing that breaks my heart as a campus pastor is to see how many people start heading down that right direction, and so quickly, they just get discouraged. They get discouraged and they step away from that. God is faithful, amen? Amen. Man, people in this campus, in this church, they just want you to know that so badly, that our God is faithful. If you're having those doubts, if you're having those struggles, reach out. Reach out, let us come by your side and encourage you, because so many people stop so close to that breakthrough, so close. So please, stay committed. Speaking of what if, I told you today that what if we did what we can do, we would have a great day, amen? Amen. Today, four people crossed that line of faith. Before you take that step, man, what an amazing step. Like Pastor Miles just said, your forever has forever changed. Today was a turning point. I want to make sure that you don't just take our word for that, but that you come up here after service. My connections team just wants to greet you, give you a copy of God's word so you can see for yourself what just took place. Man, it is a game changer, and I am so absolutely stoked for what God is going to do in and through you if you allow him to. Grant, that is pretty much the end of service. A couple quick announcements. If you would like to pray, if you maybe have a prayer request, we have a prayer team right up here on my right. So if they just want to pray, so come on up, share what you want to pray about. They would love to get to know you a little bit, pray with you, pray for you. Right after service, we're going to be having our baptisms. Give it up for those baptisms. I encourage as many as can stay to stay, just to check it out, just to celebrate what God is doing in people's lives. The pool is at the front of the school. The easiest way is to drive to the front and come in. You can walk through the school if you'd like, and then you're going to walk back to the car. The easiest way is to drive around to the front. Eddie James is already up there. The door's open. Big hug waiting if that's what you would like. Come watch these baptisms. Come celebrate what God is doing. Lastly, Pastor announced it again, was Night of Worship. Night of Worship is off the chain. Awesome. Do not miss that. Do not miss that. It'll be all over Facebook. You will want to be there, because it is where, especially for those 35% that give and serve, it will just fill that tank with so much fuel so that we can be ready for what's next. Because the next season is just going to be, like Pastor said, time is now. We are seeing God's best now. We're seeing growth week after week. We're seeing people take the steps week after week. All of our campuses, God is doing something special now. And you want to be on board. That said, I really hope you guys have a fantastic week. Now, those of you getting baptized, come see me right after service. Good week. God bless.